In this illustration, we are required to find the expansion of a ring due to a charge. Here, it is given that a ring of radius 0.1 meter is made out of a thin metallic wire of area of cross section 10 to the power minus 6 meters square, and the ring has a uniform charge of pi coulomb, and we are required to find the change in radius of ring when a charge of 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb is placed at the center of ring. We are also given with the Young modulus of the metal. And in this situation, if we solve it, we can see if we are given with a ring which is having a uniformly distributed charge on it, and see the magnitude of this charge is Q1. And if we place a charge Q2 at its center, and if both are of same polarity, due to the repulsion of Q2, the ring will have a tendency to expand. And in this situation, the ring will develop an increase in tension. So here, due to this radially outward repulsive force, we can directly calculate the tension increment in the ring, which we already studied earlier. So here we can write, due to the charge at center, tension increment in ring is, this tension we can directly write as the sum of the radial scalar force divided by 2 pi between the central charge on the radius. So this can be written as KQ1Q2 by 2 pi r square. So if I substitute the numerical values which are given over here, this can be written as K, I can write as 9 multiplied by 10 to the power 9. Q1 we are given as 10 to power minus 8. This 10 to power minus 8 is Q2, and Q1 is given as pi coulombs divided by 2 pi. The radius of ring is 0.1. So this will be 0.1 whole square. Here pi gets cancelled out, and if we simplify this result, this will give us 4500 newton. That is a tension increase in the ring. Now due to this tension, the ring will expand, and say if its initial radius is r, and this will further expand to delta r. So here we can write, if delta r is increase in radius of ring, the strain in ring can be given as delta R by R. We can also use the increase in length of ring by the initial length, that will also result delta R by R. So we can use by Hooke's law, Young's modulus of a material can be given as stress by strain. And in this situation, the value of a stress, we can write the tension increment divided by the cross-sectional area. Here I'm taking S as cross-sectional area of this ring, divided by strain. Here is delta R by R. So simplifying this expression, I'm getting the increase in radius of ring as delta R, which is equals to TR by YS. If I substitute now the numerical values, T is 4500 multiplied by radius is 0.1 divided by Young modulus we are given with 2 into 10 to the power 11, and the cross-sectional area is 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. On simplifying this, you'll be getting 2.25 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter, which is 2.25 mm. That is the increase in radius of this ring. That will be the answer to this problem.